What's up, Juicy P gang? So today I'm about to be showing you how to do this very natural, beautiful, beginner friendly makeup look. So if you are interested in seeing it, stay tuned. So of course I'm gonna start off with my brows. Just to say I'm not a professional or anything, this is what I do, so if it works for you, great. So I'm about to start with my eyebrows, and what I use for my eyebrows is this Ruby Kisses. I'm not sure what it's called for real, but this side is like a brush and the other side, so it's a two-in-one type of thing. What I'm about to do is just brush my eyebrows. And sorry guys if I'm looking to the side, I'm just looking at my mirror because it's kind of hard to look at the camera and do my makeup. So I do that, just brush my eyebrows up, and then I just straighten it like that. Then I'm about to be going in with, I'm not sure what this product is called. I got it from my beauty school. It's just a pomade. You can use any pomade you'd like, but what I like to use is black pomade. You see, as you can see, it's almost done. I really like using black, but it depends on what you guys like. Black may not fit some people. Brown may fit some people, so it's honestly just a preference thing. So I'm about to go in and get a little bit of the product on my brush, and oh yeah, I cannot see, I'm not gonna mess up trying to look at the camera. So I'm about to just outline my brows like this, starting by the middle of my brow, about like starting by the arch where the arch is, and I'm about to just very lightly apply the product. So that's the top, and I'm about to go in with the bottom. And remember you guys, you can always go back in to your pomade and get as much product as you need, but trust me, you don't need so much if you're gonna do an everyday look, but if you're gonna like fully beat your face, you usually use more pomade on your, well, personally, I usually use more pomade on my eyebrows if I'm fully beating my face, because then it just gives it more of a like darker, dramatic look. So as you can see, I applied it to a little bit before the arch to the end of my brow, and then for the beginning of my brow, since I don't want like a blocky look, I kind of just lightly brush like so in the front of my brow, so it gives kind of like a faded ombre look. So that's how it's gonna look. And then I'm about to go on to my next brow. Just another tip, when I'm doing the bottom, I kind of raise my eyebrow like just a little bit. I don't know. It helps me to make a better arch for my eyebrows. So yeah, I definitely recommend trying that tip. So now after I'm done with the pomade, I'm about to go in with an angled brush. This angled brush that I've been using for quite some time now. As you can see, this foundation and everything all over it, it just doesn't come off, but yeah. I like to just press it down and flatten my brush a little bit. Since it's an everyday look, I don't want to use too much of a bright concealer. I don't even use concealer for real. I just use a liquid foundation for focus. This is what I use. It's called Kiss New York Pro Touch Liquid Foundation in the color 345. So what I like to do is just put a little bit on the back of my hand, just a small dot, Sorry if the lighting's changing a little bit. My ring light is dying on me. So I just go in like this and get a little bit of product on the brush on both sides, like so. I like to, again, start in the middle of my brow and then work my way down and then go in the front. And then what I like to do for the top is I go in with my Fenty Beauty foundation in the color 430. Can't even show it to you guys, but it's in the color 430. And then again, I put a little dot on the back of my hand and repeat the same step on the top of my brow. And again, onto the next eyebrow. Y'all, look at me messing up. You see, it happens to everybody. It happens on your worst days and your best days. It just happens. So this is what my eyebrows are looking like. Matter of fact, I don't really like how the beginning of this is looking, so I'm gonna just put a little more pomade. Okay, now I'm about to go in with my foundation. Again, Fenty Beauty in the shade 430. I like to use my angled brush and just apply the foundation like this. And I'm gonna go in with this brush that I got from Amazon. I'm gonna leave the link down in the description box below. I'm going in with the face flat brush. And just lightly dabbing my face like this. Sometimes when the foundation gets too dry, I just use this face mist. It has witch hazel in it. Make sure you blend it down in your neck because you don't want your face to not match your neck. It's just, no, like, who wants that? Like, so make sure you blend it down to your neck about, I like to blend it about like here and just blend it like this so it's like nice and even. When I have edges and stuff like that, I like to use a smaller brush to get around like my edges so I don't get foundation on my edges, because who wants that? Like, so this brush really helps me to get around the creases of my eye here and around my edges, around my nose and around my mouth and all around here. So I really like to use this brush. Thank you. All right, you guys, now that I'm done with my foundation, I'm about to go in and apply the same foundation that I applied underneath my eyebrows. And I'm about to go in again with the angled brush and just apply it underneath my eye like this, and in a, like an acute kind of shape, I guess you could say. And again, it's all about your personal preference. Personally, I don't like to put too much, but I like to put enough, because again, it is an everyday look and you don't want to do like too much if you really want like that natural kind of look. And then I'll just like apply a little bit like this on my chin. I'm just gonna go in with this small brush and very lightly blend. You can always go in with more product if you want more of a highlight underneath your eyes. But I really like this step because it really like brightens your eyes and just makes your eyes pop. And go in with some more on top of my eyelid like this. And then again, like so. And blend, you guys, because you do not want your foundation, like, you don't want to see the line where you added the other color foundation and this foundation, because that's just gonna look like a hot mess, and like, who wants that? So really make sure you blend your product into your skin and blend the product so that they blend and look just nice and sleek and blended. Like, I don't know how else to explain it. Just make sure you blend your product nicely. After I use this product, I just start using the same flat face brush and just like blend around like where I put it at. So it kind of like blends more. It kind of just blends more with the whole look and has a more smoother transition. So after that, what I like to do is go in with this Black Radiance pressed powder in the color Ebony. Kind of like get a little bit on my brush and go in the areas that I didn't put the highlighted color. Basically, I put the product in these areas right here, under here, blend it into my neck and on top of my lip, but I don't do it on the places that I placed the highlighter. And I hope I explained that right. I'm really not good at explaining stuff, but the video will explain itself. After that step, I'm gonna go in with my eyelashes. These are the eyelashes I'm gonna be using. And for my lashes, what I like to do is go in with eyeliner. You can use eyeliner or pomade. Put it from like here to the middle of my eye. Like so. And then I'm gonna move on to the next eye. After that step, I'm just gonna go in with some mascara. The mascara I use is Maybelline the Mega Plush Volume Express. But honestly, it's your preference, whatever mascara you like to use. Some people put mascara on after they put their lashes on, but I really like to put my mascara on before I put my lashes on, because I don't know, personally I just don't like to get mascara on my lashes because I like to reuse my lashes a lot, so I don't want to get mascara on my lashes like that. So I'll just put my mascara on first. And for the glue, I'm pretty sure you heard other people say they use this as well, 30 second hair glue. Yes, it may not be the best product to use, but this is what works for me and I don't have any problems with it. And again, I showed you guys the lashes that I'm about to be using. Please, y'all, make sure you take off the excess glue that you had on your lashes from previously applying it if you reuse your lashes, because nobody wants to have buildup on their eyelashes. Some people like to use tweezers to apply their eyelashes, but I just use my fingers. Like, I find it easier to use my fingers. I never tried using tweezers, but I don't know, it's just way easier for me to use my fingers. So just using a rat tail comb and applying glue to my lashes. Part of the lash that's gonna be right here, I don't apply much glue because I don't know, I just don't. And like, that's way too close to comfort to my tear duct. So like, I'm just not messing around with that. So I'm just let it dry for a little bit. So like so. And voila, you applied your lash. So now I'm about to do the same exact thing for my other eye. These are 30mm eyelashes, but if you want your look to be more natural, I would go with a shorter lash length. And when you do the middle first, the beginning and the end kind of just like falls in place. So you don't really have to do too much. So after I apply my eyelashes, I go back in with my mascara and just very lightly go over my bottom lashes. So this is it. And then for my lips, it's just, I don't even know if they sell these for real still. I got this in high school. It's called Simply Sweet Orange Sherbet Lip Balm. I don't know if you guys can see that. So I use this and just put it over my lips. You don't have to put too much. Yes, you guys, I know it looks crazy right now, but just trust the process, okay? Trust the process. So then I go in with Staining Mood Gloss by Ruby Kisses in Honey. As you can see, it was like white before. What this does is it kind of just like evens it out, just kind of like tones it out so it's not so white. And when you first apply it, it still kind of looks white, but it is a mood changing gloss, so it kind of changes and like kind of changes to like this like purpley natural kind of look. Honestly, really, the camera's not really doing this look much justice, but y'all, this is my everyday makeup look. I really love it. This is the end of my everyday makeup tutorial. I really don't do too much when it comes to like my everyday makeup look. It's very simple. It's just like if you want something on your face, you know, not too much, but natural. Not doing too much. This is what you can do to achieve this look. If you liked this tutorial, if you like this video, make sure you let me know in the comment section down below. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. And anything that you guys do for your makeup look, make sure you let me know down below. I always like trying new things when it comes to like makeup or just trying new things in general. So let me know what you guys like to do with your makeup or your everyday makeup, or if you have any questions, I'll answer it. So yeah, y'all, thanks for watching. Bye.